Hi everyone, my name is Judy Tai and welcome to PSTV's workshop on making GIFs. Now what is a GIF? GIF stands for Graphics Interchange Format, and this is a file format created by Steve Wilhite back in 1987. It is a sequence of images played over time. It differs from video formats like MP4s and movie files because GIFs do not contain video controls like play and restart. GIFs by default automatically play on open or in the browser, and you can only pause them. Now, the original creator pronounced it with a soft G, GIF, so I'm going to honor that. So what is a GIF good for? Well, if you're on the internet, and especially on social media, you will see people posting and commenting with GIFs to better convey their emotion. Those are called reaction GIFs. Social media platforms like Facebook and Twitter are built in with an option to post or comment with a GIF, and by searching with a keyword, you'll see hundreds of GIFs that have been tagged with that emotion. Most of the time, these GIFs are of celebrities or actors in TV shows, movies, animations, and more. So how do we make one ourselves to share with the world? Well, I'm going to show you four different ways that you can get started making GIFs. First, we'll look at how we can convert photos and videos through Photoshop, and then we'll convert a YouTube video into a GIF, and then we'll learn how to make a GIF using your phone, and finally, we'll do some screen recording on your computer screen and make a GIF that way. So, let's get started. The first method to make a GIF is with Adobe Photoshop. You'll need a series of photos or a short video. And right here, you can see that I have some photos that are numerically named and a short video here. It's all related to Rubik's Cube. So to import the photos, we're going to go into File, Scripts. Load files into Stack. And when you click this, we can browse for our images. And I'm just going to click on the first one, hold Shift if you're on Windows and Mac. And then click on the last image while holding Shift to have all of them selected. I'm going to press OK. And now we have our queue of files to load in. And all we really need to do is press OK. And it's going to make a new Photoshop document and run the script, and now you can see all of our files are being loaded. Now, to get this into a timeline, a Photoshop timeline, first we want to make sure that you have the timeline enabled. So you want to go into Window up here and make sure the checkbox in their timeline is selected so that we have, you know, our timeline open. Next, we want to go and make a frame animation. This bottom arrow here can make us switch between video timeline and frame animation. We definitely want to do frame animation, so make sure you do that. Click on that button, and it'll make our first layer into a frame. To get all of the layers into here as frames, we can go and select this little hamburger stack on the top right of our timeline and make frames from layers. And that'll make all of our layers into frames. But the problem now is that the frames are reversed. I have it so that it starts from unfinished to finished Rubik's Cube. And here it's starting from finished Rubik's Cube to unfinished Rubik's Cube. So in order to reverse the frames, we're going to go back to the hamburger stack on the top right of our timeline. And we're going to click on reverse frames. And that'll take care of that. If you want to change the duration of each frame, which essentially changes how fast your animation is going, then you want to hit the first frame, just have it selected, hold Shift, and click on the last frame to have all of the frames selected. And we're going to go down to this little drop-down arrow menu thing, and you can select from a preset of frame durations here. These are all in seconds. Or we can input a custom time. So again, it's going to be in seconds. I want it to be 0.15 seconds. And press OK. And now we can see that our animation is a lot slower than before because we increased the frame duration. I'm pretty happy with this, but before you export it, I'm going to show you how to import a video now. So to import a video, You can go into File, Import, right here, and Video Frames to Layers. Now this will make a new Photoshop document. I'm going to select my video here and press Open. And it's going to make a new Photoshop document, so I don't have to worry about this document we have open already. But when you press Import Video to Layers and you select the video, it's going to ask you if you want to import it from beginning to end or if you just want to import it from a selected range only. And you can use the trim controls down here to pick what range you want your video to be in. In this case, I want it from beginning to end, and I'm going to click on this checkbox to limit to every X amount of frames. You want to do this if you're doing a video so that you can limit the number of frames that get imported into your Photoshop file and therefore reduce the file size of your resulting GIF. In this case, this video, I am not sure what FPS it was recorded in, but I would imagine it's at least 24 FPS. I want to limit it to every 15 frames so that I don't get too many frames into my timeline. All right, and to explain a little bit more in depth about this little part of importing your videos and, you know, trying to decide how many frames to limit it by, let's say my video was at 24 frames per second. And that means that we have basically a graph that represents time. So this would be 0 seconds. And this would be 1 second of duration. And we have 24 frames inside of that duration. I don't think this is 24 frames, but, you know, imagine this is 24 frames, which means that each frame is playing at 1/24th of a second. And this isn't just for, you know, 1 second of video. We're continuing this along. So it will keep going upwards to, you know, 2 seconds and beyond. And when we want to limit it to be every 15 frames, I want every 15th frame in the video. So this essentially means that I am only picking this frame and this frame, which is the 30th frame, and every multiple of 15 frames, and I'm discarding every other frame in between. I'm not using those frames. I'm only using these two frames that will actually get imported into my my timeline in Photoshop. So that is kind of a visual representation or explanation of what it means to import every X amount of frame from your video into Photoshop. And of course, have a checkbox to make a frame animation. You want all of that selected. So press OK. It'll do its thing, and now we're in a new document. So this is my video file, and this is my photo series. In my video file, I can see that I have a timeline full of the frames, and it's going to be longer than our photo series because it's a longer video. It seems choppy because we limited it to every 15th frame, but that's okay. So it's actually a pretty long GIF, but that is fine. You might want to play around with the import option to limit it to more frames or less frames. So that's just a value you're going to have to play with. I'm kind of happy with this so far. I just wanted it to be a GIF, and I didn't want it to have all of the frames in there. So now we're going to move on to exporting our GIF. Now this step is going to be the same for both file types of whether or not you started with a photo series or if you started from a video. They're just going to be the same method. We're going to go to File and then Export, Save for Web Legacy. It's going to open up a new window, and it's going to kind of process your animation here so that we can see your preview of it ready to go. Now, while that's loading, I'm going to go over some important options that you can set for your GIF. So up here, we have a preset, and what you can do is you can change the file type. Here we have it listed as a GIF. You can change it to JPEG and PNG, but that would mean that you're not making a GIF, you're just making an image. So if you want it to be an animated GIF, obviously set it to be a GIF. We can change the algorithm that the GIF is loaded with. So because a GIF is just a series of images, it needs some way to cut down on its file size. So how it does that is it makes a pattern of the colors. So right now our GIF is loaded and it's actually very big. Down here we can see the image size and our width is in the thousands. And we want it to be pretty low. I want it to be about 800 pixels wide. And that's about 20% as big as the original. I'm going to click outside of the dialog box and it'll kind of resize the image. It'll take its time to do that. So now we can see the full GIF here. So back to the preset, we can choose an algorithm for it to select how it selects the colors. Perceptual is fine. You can experiment with these other ones. I'm not going to get too much into it. For the colors up here, you can decide how many colors it's allowed to have in the palette. As you can see, we have a color table that shows all of the different colors that is available. And you can see how big your file size is going to be by going to the bottom left here. You can see that it's about 1.854 megabytes. And that is a really good size for your GIF. It's small, it's short. You can post this on social media because sites like Twitter has a file size limit for media that you're uploading. So this is in target. I'm pretty happy with all of this, so we can hit save. Or actually, we can preview it and see how it looks. It looks pretty funky. I like it. So we're going to save, and I'm just going to save it in where I want this to be. I'm just going to pick my my workshop folder with where I'm creating this workshop, and then I'm going to select or name this Rubik's Cube and press save. Now it's exported it out, and we can actually go find that file, Rubik's Cube GIF. Now I can double click this, and we have a GIF. Now you have a file that you can upload anywhere you want on Twitter or Facebook or whatever. So that is the first method of making a GIF, is using Photoshop. So the second way to make a GIF is from a YouTube video, and we're going to use GIPHY.com. This is a great site that you can make GIFs from, and you can decorate your GIFs, add stickers, add effects, do all sorts of things, add some text as well. I think GIPHY is probably like the leading GIF provider because so many people upload their GIFs, they add tags to those GIFs. And these are actually the GIFs that you might be seeing when you search up a GIF when you make a social media post, when you're looking for a reaction GIF. So GIPHY has a great library on GIFs. And how many times have I said GIF so far? So again, we're going to make a GIF from a YouTube video. I already have a video loaded up. It's essentially of Kirby eating some rice. I'm a huge Kirby fan. So what you need to do is find a YouTube video, copy the URL. I'm just going to go up here to the address bar and hit Control C to copy it, or Command C if you're on Mac. And I'm going to go to GIPHY.com. I'm already logged in, but you don't need to log in or create an account. You hit Create up here. And you can see that there are a few ways you can make GIFs from GIPHY.com. You can upload your own from pictures or from movies. You can do some interesting things. I don't even know what these are, but from a YouTube video down here, any URL, you can paste your video. It actually automatically moves forward in the dialogue. So yeah, this is the video that I want to make a GIF out of, and here are some options that you have to trim your video. Firstly is the duration that you want your GIF to be. So it starts off at 4 seconds. You can make it as long as 15. I think 4 seconds is pretty good. And then you can choose where you want your GIF to start and end, or their, the start time. So I'm gonna kind of find a really good, cute spot. Oh, look at the sparkly eyes from Kirby, and he's just like blowing on his rice. It's really nice. I think this is a great place to make a GIF. So I'm gonna continue to decorate, and we have a lot more options to do. It's loading right now, but we can add a caption, as you can see here. Enter your caption. We can change that caption color, change the style of that text, and animate that text. So we're gonna do some really interesting things. I'm gonna make something here where I love rice, because I do love rice. Maybe make it a rainbow so it has a little rainbow effect. We can actually hover over the preview to change the position of our caption. Change the color. I don't think this matters so much. Yeah, you can change the color of it, but if you're doing a rainbow effect, it doesn't matter what color it is. You can change the fonts or style of your caption, and it's down here. I don't know what that is about, but this is okay. I love rice. We can add some stickers. Just up here, we have caption stickers, filters, and draw. We're gonna add some stickers. Personally, I think I'm gonna pass on the stickers. Maybe add some hearts. Always love to add some hearts to the scene. Let's see here. I'm gonna click on this. There you go. You click on it, and then it'll kind of spawn in the preview, and you can resize it and move the position and add some filters. Let's see here. VHS. Oh, that is really cool. Bad TV. Yeah, these are really cool. Yeah, I really, really love it. I like the cross process. It makes it more saturated. And then we can also draw on our GIF. So we can kind of, I'm not sure what any of these are actually, but I'm gonna choose a color and we can kind of draw on here. I'm gonna maybe try a funky option, the stars here. What does that do? Oh, so yeah, the stars, you can make like a path of sparkle. So I'm gonna do that over his outline and we get him sparkling. Really cool. Yeah, I haven't used Jiffy a lot, but this seems like a really, really awesome way to make some GIFs. So I'm going to continue to upload, or we can start over if you're not happy with what you have. But for me, I'm going to continue to upload. And we're going to add some info to our GIF. So source URL, you always want to include where you got the source of your GIF. And we're going to add some tags here. For example, I'm going to tag it Kirby. And make sure you put a comma after your tag. Actually, use a space between the tags. That's what it says in the tag tips. Make sure you cover over the tag tips. Do not include the hashtag. Keep tags relevant. Use spaces between the words and tag the emotions and reactions. So, yeah, this is really important because your GIF might be presented in the search for reaction GIFs, so when you're, posting on social media and whatnot. You can make this public or private. So if you only want to have access to your GIF, you don't want it to share it to anyone, or I mean, you don't want it to be public so that people can search it, that's fine. I'm gonna keep it public because I think this is not very personal to me. Like, who doesn't love rice and who doesn't love Kirby? So yeah, I'm gonna tag it Kirby. I'm gonna tag it rice. I'm gonna tag it cute. And I think that's fine. So I think you can also add tags with the plus here. So I'm gonna do that again. Kirby plus rice and cute. Okay. So yeah, we're gonna upload to Jiffy. And when you upload, it's going to process and create your GIF and give it some time here to rev up the engines. All right, after some minutes, we have our GIF, and it also shows the stickers that we use. It seems like it also trimmed down on the tags. Maybe cute was a little too repetitive, but that's okay. And now we have our GIF. So what we can do from here is we can see it full screen. I'm not sure what any of these buttons do, to be fair. But most importantly, we can copy the link. And when you click on copy link, you can have the short link, the GIF link, and HTML5 video. Very interesting. Personally, I would just use the short link and post it on your social medias to accompany your post if you want this specific GIF. So yeah, there you have it, making a GIF from a video using GIPHY.com. So the third way to make a GIF is using your phone. And here I have the Google Play Store open. I'm going to look up GIPHY and install the GIPHY app on my Android phone. And I'm just going to give it some time to install here. We're just going to enjoy this brief noise from me talking while this is loading. Okay, it has finished downloading, and now that it is installing, all right, it's done. So now I'm going to open it, and here we are in Jiffy. You can press that button to get started, and what you'll do is make an account, and I'm just going to quickly make an account, and we'll be right back. All right, now that we're in Jiffy, the app, what we can do is in the very top right corner here, we're going to hit create. And what that'll do is, hello, that's a video of me. You can take photos. So what I'm gonna do here is I have a Rubik's Cube and I can just take a photo, take a burst of photos. That didn't work out so well. So what we can do is actually hold the button, that white button in the middle, to hold. So it's kind of like taking a Snapchat video. You can see it kind of record here, and once it's done, we have a GIF of our recording. So it's about 6 seconds and 6.5 seconds long. What I can do is hit continue, and we can actually add some text here. So I can add something like cool, and we can move it. So it's a lot like working with Snapchat if you've ever used anything like that. We can add some effects here, some really cool effects. There's a lot going on. I kind of like this barrel and effect here. Yeah, the barrel one is pretty cool. And we can also add some stickers. So it's a lot like using the web browser version of Jiffy. But I'm gonna add some sparkles. I guess an emoji works, right? This one is fine. And we can resize it by dragging our pictures and pinching. So, and we can also trim the animation or the GIF. So we can choose the beginning and choose when it ends, and each little block here represents a second of the GIF. So I'm pretty happy with this. I'm gonna hit continue and press the purple arrow on the bottom right, and it's processing. And what you will see is that your GIF is ready to upload. So I'm gonna make this public. And what I'm going to do is add some tags like Rubik's Cube and hit that plus sign and hit cool. I guess that might be a little redundant. And we can upload to Jiffy or we can share the GIF. So I'm going to hit share GIF and now you can see you can share your GIF anywhere. So Facebook Messenger, text, Snapchat, Instagram. Those are all of the icons. You can save it as a video or save it as a GIF. And this is a way to create and share GIFs using your phone. It's very easy, very straightforward. All right, so the last method is if you want to record your screen on a computer or a laptop or anything like that, there are apps available like GIPHY Capture, which is for Macs. I'm running on a Windows, however, so I can't use that. In this video, I'll be showing how to get ScreenToGIF, which is this little app shortcut right here. So to get it, we're just gonna go in and screen to GIF. And we have the first link, ScreenToGIF.com. We're gonna click on that first result. And here we are, ScreenToGIF. I already have the installer. So you just download the installer, it's for Windows, and you can just run it and it'll install on your computer. So do that. And now we have a ScreenToGIF. Now, when you double click on the app, it'll open up this window where you can take a GIF of anything that's happening on your screen. So that's really cool. What can we do with this? Well, one example is maybe you want to, show some steps, right? Like you want to have probably like a stepper or maybe record anything that's happening on your screen. Honestly, there can be a lot of things going on, right? So, for example, I'm just gonna record my Google app right here. We're gonna hit on recorder and it'll open up this window. It's kind of like a frame. So, you're framing your GIF. So, we can frame it to be this entire window. I think if we click on this, it'll be the entire window and just kind of drag it on there. But I don't want it to be the entire window. I just kind of want it to be frame it down to the just this Google app here. So we can kind of show like a GIF of some search results, right? So we have some options down here on the bottom right. We have the settings, which is the options. A lot of options here. I'm not going to go through that. We can set the frames per second of our GIF. 15 frames per second is pretty good. And this kind of so like shows the size of your resulting GIF. So this is actually a really interesting tool to use. So I'm going to hit record and we can record some stuff like PSTV Philadelphia, right? And it'll kind of show up and we can actually move this while it's recording and kind of show the first result here. And that's, I think, enough for a GIF. 15 seconds is enough for me. Then we kind of get another window that has all of our frames. I'm just kind of scrolling through it. All of our frames on here. And if we hit play in the bottom right here, we have some playhead controls or video controls. We can hit this. And now we can see our GIF. This is a really cool tool to use if you're making any GIFs to record, like a tutorial video, like I am right now, or having a GIF of anything that's happening on your screen. Personally, as a game developer, I use it to record gameplay to kind of share with my social media, to present the new features that I add in my games and any animations and art and anything like that. So, yeah. This is Screen to GIF. You can go into File and Save As. I think there are also some options here. You can edit this so we can kind of remove some frames if we don't want them. We can hold Shift to select multiple frames and delete them if we wanted to, or delete everything after this frame we selected, or everything before the frame we selected. We can reverse. Reverse the animation and makes the animation go forward and backwards. So it's kind of like a boomerang or a yo-yo, and other options here. But for simple purposes, we're just gonna do save as, and it'll open up or slide this options menu here to save as. We can use a default palette or a screen to GIF encoder and save it as a GIF. So this is pretty good. You also have the option to save it as a video if you want, or export it to Photoshop as video frame layers or frame animation. So you have some options here. Honestly, I'm not gonna mess. too much with this, except maybe change the name and the file location. So hitting that little folder on the right of the file location will open up a window so you can decide where you want to save this. So I'm saving it in here and select the folder, and then you can name it. So I'm just going to name this PSTV Google search, right? Dot GIF, and we can hit save, and it'll process it out. Doesn't take too long, and the GIF is going to be 1.3 megabytes, so that's actually a really good size if I wanted to post this on a blog or something about, showing what PSTV is all about. So I'm actually going to go find that GIF here, and you can see all the images that I used in this video. Let's see, PSTV Google search. We're going to double click that and kind of see what we got here. So this is a really cool way to make a GIF recording of anything that's happening on your screen. Highly recommend it. It's free. It saves it straight to your computer, and you can upload this GIF wherever you want. So yeah. If you've gotten this far in the video, thank you so much for watching. I really had a lot of fun exploring the different ways to make a GIF. Just as a review, I've listed here the four ways you can make a GIF. So again, if you have photos or if you're starting with a video, go to Photoshop. If you have a YouTube URL, go to Giphy.com. If you just have a phone, you can use the Giphy app. If you want to record something on your computer screen, then use ScreenToGIF. Again, thank you so much for watching PSTV's workshop tutorial on making GIFs, and I hope to see you in future tutorials.